Today, I have 10 tips for you, 10 color grading tips in DaVinci Resolve 18 or 18.5 that not only you, but also your friends, your partner, your parents, and even your dog should know.
Huh?
So let them all know about this video because I'm 100% sure that after watching it, you'll be like, wow, that one tip, what a lifesaver. So yeah, here we go. And first, we have the layer node. Now, you can use a layer node for many things, but I mainly use it for the skin tones when I'm color grading, to avoid the skin tones from looking too green or too blue, for example. Basically, to keep the skin tones looking clean. Now, how does it work? Well, you probably all know how you can make a mask or a selection of the skin tones, right? With the qualifier tool, just select the skin tones, something like this, denoise it a bit, and then you can start adjusting and correcting the skin tones. How? Well, that depends on what your original footage looks like, of course. You can use the color wheels, offset, temperature, tint, and of course, always check in the vector scope where the skin tones are. They should be on or close to the skin tone line. But then, once you've got the skin tones where you want them, maybe you want to work on the background or some other colors. And of course, you don't want all that work that you just did on the skin tones to go to waste. Well, then you can add a layer node. So add another node, select it, and then hit Option or Alt plus L to create a layer node. Connect the blue dotted line here, and now the skin tones are layered on top of this node. So everything you do here in this node, a heavy color grade for example, won't affect the skin tones. See? Whatever you do here. This is exaggerated, of course, but it's just to show you what it does. And of course, you can also adjust the opacity to blend the skin tones with that new color grade. And it's all about having control. You decide what happens, and not Resolve. Now, when you're color grading, sometimes you might get the feeling that something looks off, but you don't know what. And often it's dirty shadows or dirty highlights. For example, if the shadows have a slight bluish color cast or a teal color cast, something like this. But of course, again, this is exaggerated to show you what it looks like. But even if it's very subtle, it might still look off, but it's super easy to fix. Just go to the curves here and then luminance versus saturation. And here you can tweak the saturation of the highlights or the shadows. So the shadows are on the left, highlights on the right. And all you need to do is make an extra anchor point here and bring down the saturation for, in this case, the shadows. Now, be careful. Make sure you don't get too much of the shadows. So adjust this point here. Because at some point, also the midtones will be affected. And then it might start looking weird. So keep it subtle. The darkest shadows, clean black. That's what you want. It's a very subtle adjustment, but it makes a huge difference. Adjustment clips. I use them for everything. Also for color grading, because they allow you to apply a color grade to multiple clips or a section of clips. And so you can also use them to copy paste a color grade. Super useful. So first look for the adjustment clip here in effects. Drop it onto your footage. Select the clip and make sure the playhead is over the clip, and then go to the color page. Do your color grading, which will be happening in the adjustment clip now. I'll just apply a LUT here. And when you're done, you can move that adjustment clip, which is also the color grade, and make it longer, shorter, copy it, whatever you want. I use adjustment clips all the time for everything. But if you don't want to use adjustment clips because you don't love them, which is weird, but okay, I'm not judging here. Well, then you can always use power grades, and the name says it, power grades are even more powerful. In the color page, let's say you have a color grade with a bunch of nodes and effects, and you want to use this color grade on multiple clips in your project, but also other projects. Well, go to gallery here and select power grades. Right click in the image here and hit grab still. And now your grades with all the nodes and effects will be saved here in a still, a power grade. And all you need to do now, if you have an ungraded clip, just click on a power grade. And boom, all the nodes, all the effects will appear. And stills here is pretty much the same, but you can only use these in this project. And the ones that you save in power grades, you can use in all your projects, past projects and future projects. I actually really love power grades too, but don't tell the adjustment clips, okay? Next is false color. So sometimes it's difficult to get the exposure of the skin tones right, the face for example, especially when the lighting conditions are difficult or weird. But there's an easy way to always get it right, or at least a way to accurately get feedback. Go here to effects in the color page and look for the false color effect. Drop it onto a node, and now you know exactly what the exposure of the skin is. It should always be around 60 IRE. Now, of course, it depends on the lighting conditions and the color of the skin. Dark skin will be lower, under 60 even, and white skin in dim lighting conditions should also be lower. But then outside in the bright sun, you might have to go over 70. It even depends on the look you're going for. But this way, you always know exactly what the exposure of the skin is. Again, it's all about having control. And by the way, do you like the title cards in this video? Well, I made them with the help of Storyblocks, the sponsor of this video. So I went to Storyblocks and then animated backgrounds and, well, they have a ton of them. Modern, vintage, colorful, dark, whatever your style is, you'll find it. But Storyblocks also has stock footage, templates, images, everything to make your creative work easier and faster, because time is one of the most valuable things we have, right? If you're also a creative, you probably know what I'm talking about. Everything's high quality and royalty free, so you can use Storyblocks assets for YouTube and social media, but also for client work. And with the subscription, you get unlimited downloads. So you'll save a lot compared to those expensive pay-per-clip models. Go check them out by using my link, storyblocks.com/yourishermans, in the description. And thank you, Storyblocks, for sponsoring my video. Color management. I've made a few videos about it. I'll link them in the description in case you want to check them out. But yeah, so I always use color space transforms to get my log footage in the Rec. 709 color space. But if you don't like color space transforms, you can also let DaVinci Resolve do it automatically. Just go to project settings here, then color management, and set the color science to DaVinci color managed. And then the output color space, well, usually it's Rec. 709, hit save. And now two things might happen. Or DaVinci Resolve recognizes your footage and will bring it into the Rec. 709 color space automatically. As soon as you drop it onto your timeline, in the color tab, go to Camera Raw, and then here you can check if Resolve recognizes your footage or not. If nothing's there, then it doesn't. But don't worry, all you have to do then is right-click on a clip or clips and select the input color space. And then Resolve will bring your log into Rec. 709 without using a color space transform. Easy peasy. Next tip, enable qualifier focus. It's super simple tool, but really, really helpful. In the color page here, click the three dots and enable qualifier focus. And now when you hover over your image, you can see here in the vector scope where those colors and tones are. So you can check real quick if the skin tones, for example, are actually on the skin tone line. But you can also see it in the waveform. And here you can check, for example, if your white balance is correct. If you hover over a white part of the image and you only see one ring here, it means that it's true white and that the white balance is correct. If it separates into three rings, then your white balance is off. A very useful little tool. Comparing clips. It's something you'll have to do quite often when you're color grading a project with multiple clips, all with different lighting conditions and colors and scenes, because of course you want them to match. So to easily compare them, in the color page here, turn on split screen and then select selected clips. And now, whenever you select two clips, they will show next to each other and it will make it a lot easier to color match. You can even see both the waveforms here. Are you still with me? Your brain is not overheating? Because if it is, then the next tip is for you. It's a mistake I used to make a lot whenever I was color grading, but also editing photos, for example. Not taking a break, because after 2 hours or 3 hours of editing the same footage, so you're staring at the same image, the same colors for hours, well, at some point, your brain starts to deceive you. You might think that what you're doing looks great, but then when you take a break and you come back after a few hours and look at it with fresh eyes, chances are that it doesn't look so great after all. And it's just because you were looking at the same image, the same colors for way too long, and your brain just can't handle that. It needs a break. So don't make your color grading sessions too long. In the end, it will save you a lot of time and frustration. Mask tracking. It's actually super easy. Let's say you want to lighten or darken a part of a face, for example. So you create a mask, soften it, and then adjust the exposure a little bit. Like this, for example. and you're like, oh, it looks great. But you forgot that it's a video. It happens, okay? And everything moves, of course. But the mask is stationary. It doesn't move. Well, don't worry. Just go here to tracking, hit this button here, and Resolve will track the movement, and the mask will stay on the face. And that's it, guys. I hope that at least one of these tips will make your color grading a bit easier, faster. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.